Breathing, very important for you, let alone for your engine. If it's not clear what we are going to talk about today, I have to tell you now that we are going to talk about intake manifolds, and not one, but two of them.
And the whole nerve-wracking scene, for that matter, is taking itself so seriously,
and we don't like it.
You can take whatever the fuck you have,
take it and
go out and drive it.
So this is the first intake manifold that has been specifically designed for rear-wheel drive K-series cars. You know this logo, you have seen it before, KMiata, now called K-Power Industries, as the guys are exploring new platforms and expanding, which is very cool, Kswap the world. And you also heard me saying before that I'm very specific in the way that I want to build this car, particularly in what has to do with the engine bay. The other manifold I showed you before is perfectly fine, it works very good, but it didn't meet exactly the requirements I wanted for my car, for the way I want to build the car. Here comes K-Power with this awesome piece of intake. It actually ticks all the boxes and then some. And now it's time for me to show you in detail why this part is so cool and why you want to have it in your rear-wheel drive K-Series. One of the coolest things about this intake is that it looks very, very stock. I didn't want an intake manifold that looked aftermarket or that was screaming aftermarket in your face. And the organic shape, the round shapes of this nicely cast manifold actually appealed to my eye. And that's why I decided to click a couple of buttons and get it here. Since we are talking about shapes, you can have a look at the overall design of the item, starting by the plenum, which is a big 3-liter one. Good for built engines, good for turbo and big, high power, naturally aspirated engines, but also good for engines like mine, which are mildly modified, only top end modifications. The short block is actually completely stock. Eventually, we're going to be able to see this on the dyno, so stay tuned for that. One of the shortcomings of having your K-Series engine rotated from 90 degrees into that longitudinal position that we so much love is that, of course, the pulley stuff is going to be on the way. Your alternator, your air conditioning, water pump, etc. is going to interfere with the throttle body. And of course, that's a problem because you actually have to cut up half of the water pump, remove the idler pulley, sometimes ditch the air conditioning, relocate the alternator, etc., etc., which is now a thing of the past. Thanks to this intake, you can actually leave everything as it is from the factory. The location of the throttle body is particularly important. You can actually see the difference between these two manifolds there. And even though it doesn't look like a lot, this rotation is very important. And that means that this K-Power Industries item can be dropped directly into your engine without any further modification done to the pulley stuff. Let's have a look underneath. The main feature here is the idle air control valve, which, as you might recognize, is a completely original Honda shape. So of course you can bolt directly the part there and forget about that. Are you running a track car? You don't need an ECV valve. Just get a block of plate, bolt it there and forget about it. The cool thing about this though is that if you need to have it, you're going to have it and it's not going to be visible. It's going to be tucked underneath nice and clean. Up until now, with other solutions, you probably would have to get a block that is completely detached from the intake manifold, build it remotely, not looking cool, not looking clean, which is completely the opposite of what you see here. Another mention for the throttle cable bracket, which of course, as it's going underneath, is not going to be visible from the top, resulting in a very clean intake. K-Power Industries offers three options for this product: K20, K24 and K24 Z4. This is a K20 item without the water port at the end. K24 gets that extra water port there ready for you, and the K24 Z4 will get you also the extra larger ports for the newer style injectors. Enough with the manifold, let's just have a quick look about everything else that you need to put the whole lot together, starting with the gasket. And actually the sensors, which are all of them original Honda parts, which of course makes everything easier. A bolt kit, so you can just drop it into the block. You have seen the block off plate before, as I'm not going to run the IACV block for now. Throttle body, very important, together with the gasket, etc. And I say very important in this case because it's not a K-series throttle body, it's a B-series throttle body. Why? A, because it's mechanical, B, because there is no water running through it, and C, because the TPS doesn't fail like in the K-series throttle body. So to me, the simplicity and the, you know, mechanical look of this one is going to make a difference. As I told you before, I'm very particular about the way I want my engine to be. Enough talking, I think it's now time to take all the shiny parts. I have been looking at them for more time than they actually deserve, because what they actually deserve is to be made to the engine. I actually cannot wait to have everything nice and ready to go. So I think it's time to take everything and go down. So bolting the intake onto the block is probably the easiest thing of the whole process. Next is the throttle body, which goes in with a simple 6mm Allen. There we go, map sensor. It's the original piece with just a normal 10mm screw. TPS, remember this is a B-series throttle body and TPS. Cool thing as well is that KMiata has orientated the sensors in a way that wires go below the whole lot together with the throttle body cable, which you are not going to see because it's literally underneath. You, in your house, that you want to see this car lapping that track. You probably have seen that towards the end of the video there was a strange light and maybe some background noises in the shape of a Mercedes. That is again coming, so you're going to listen to it again. And you are like, why are these guys bolting or mocking up an intake in the open? Like, you know, they have a workshop and they are in the Eiffel. It's cold, I have like 4 layers. Well, you probably have many questions. You can drop them in the comments. Unfortunately, I have no answers. But you can see that the car is loaded in a trailer. It's attached, it's strapped and everything. So I can tell you that the car is going places. I don't know if it's coming back. Hopefully, it's coming back and it's going to do good things. And yeah, I don't know. Just give us your theory of where this car is going and what is happening next. If you want some answers though, I believe it's going to be another couple of years down the road. Maybe we have another video finishing this car and maybe even lapping a cool track throughout Europe. So let us know if you're still interested. If you're not, I don't know. I just might as well scrap it and carry on going.
I know what you have been thinking, why there is no videos, and I will tell you why there is no videos. I have been forcing Serxio to do this simple filming that you saw for at least a couple of months. This car is getting done. It's getting done this year, not another year, not in a couple of years. So please leave some comments below and let's get this guy to finish the car. I don't care in which country, I don't care in which continent, I don't want to know the location. I just want to see this car run. And most importantly, I want my V6 car to be faster than this fucking Honda seat, huh?